So last lecture we learned about several key sorting, that means also called as counting sort and not comparison sort. Okay, so another important concept is internal and external sorting. So up to now we have discussed about what is sorting, what are the sorting methods comes under this sorting, but we don't know exactly which sorting methods are comes under internal sorting and external sorting. So before that, we have to know what is internal sorting, what is external sorting. That is very important. Okay, let us quickly go to the topic sorting. Okay, sorting is, you know, definition very well. Sorting is arrangement of or reorder the elements either ascending or descending order as per the user requirement. Okay, so now here sorting is classified into two types: internal sorting and external sorting. Okay, but to how to know why those sorting methods is called as a internal sorting, why other sorting methods fall under external sorting, we are going to depth in detail. Okay, so one thing you have to observe the difference internal and external sorting. So first go for internal sorting. Internal sorting, the data and sorting process done at within primary memory RAM. Why the data and sorting is done in primary memory itself means internal sorting always take less length of data only, which is the suitable data size in the primary memory, that is a RAM. Okay, it does not take huge length of memory. Okay, so internal sorting is very fast than the external sorting. We go in detail how it is faster than to external sorting. Okay, so here the point is data is and sorting within done at within primary memory. Okay, so let us see what are the example sorting methods under the internal sorting. Okay, so examples. Okay, so insertion sort, selection sort, bubble sort, shell sort, quick sort, and any other sorting methods is there, all are comes under the one sorting algorithm, that is internal sorting, except one. What is that? We discuss. Okay, so these sorting mechanisms we discussed or we learned in existing classes, previous sessions already we learned about these insertion sort, selection sort, bubble sort, every sorting methods in detail. But we now only focus on external sorting. So what is the definition of external sorting? Okay, data take from the secondary memory, that means hard disk, sorting process done at primary memory. So one thing you have to observe here, the data we fetch from secondary memory, in the sense the data size is exceed the capacity of the RAM. Okay, so RAM capacity is a minimum compared to the hard disk, so we can't able to copy entire size of file into RAM directly. Okay, it is impossible. Data is not able to store at RAM, so that's why from the entire file size we are taking only some portion of the data, some chunk of the data, chunk in the sense some portion of the data. So always we are pick some portion of the data into the RAM, in RAM do the sorting process, RAM do the sorting process, after sorting that resultant information again store back to the hard disk. Then again pick some data, again do the sorting, again store back to the hard disk. So this is the process of external sorting. I said just few minutes back, internal sorting is very fast. Why? No need to fetch the data from any hard disk. The primary memory itself having the data, there itself we are doing the sorting process. It takes more time external sorting because always we are depending on hard disk to fetch the data and do the sorting. Again, the result data will be stored back to hard disk. So that is a time consuming process. But which sorting method is do such kind of activity? That is one and only merge sort. One and only merge sort. Merge sort only the method to do the external sorting. Except merge sort, all the sorting techniques comes under the internal sorting. Keep it, remember this point. Okay, so this is about, next go in detail. Okay, so this is the diagrammatic representation of what I said earlier. Okay, sorting, internal, external. Internal, not only five sorting, all the sorting methods comes under the internal sorting except the merge sort. Okay, except the merge sort. So next, okay, this is a definition of, if anybody want, pause the video and note the definition. Okay, so internal sorting, any data sorting process that take place entirely within the main memory. What I said earlier, this is the same definition. Okay, external sorting is required when the data is being sorted to not fit into the main memory computing device, and instead of they must decide of the slower external memory. Okay, this is what I said. This is totally same. Here the data is always fetched from the external storage device, some portion of the data, and do the sorting on the main memory, and the sorted result again store back to the hard disk or external memory or secondary memory, again take the some portion of the data. Okay, so this is a continuous process until to complete entire data portion in the hard disk. Okay, so next step, go in detail. It diagrammatically represent how this process is done external. So we are just now we are focused on external sorting only, because of we already learned about internal sorting. Don't bother about that. We know how to sorting. So that is also done within the main memory. So okay, so this is a way what I discussed just few minutes back. So here having a hard disk, here having a hard disk, hard disk always having huge amount of data, huge amount of data, but the same length of data not able to stored at RAM. So we are only fetch some portion of the data from the hard disk, do the sorting in the primary memory, and the result again store into the secondary. Here disk, both are same, don't confuse. We are taking here, do the processing and store back to the same hard disk in sorted order, resultant order. Okay, so here see, observe this first disk having some not in order. You can, one portion is some other place, one portion is another place, but these two portions make into the finally in sorted order. That means very closer to each other. Okay, so in again with example how it is sorting. Okay, example. Okay, this is the original file actually stored in the hard disk 78 45 5 58 88 36 9 11 12, but this size example, this length of file is not able to store at RAM. So then what we can do, dividing the entire file into some chunks is some parts. Okay, so that's why the it can show the first phase only take 7845. Okay, 7845. Second phase remaining this, second, third phase and fourth. So that means some portion, four portions, and do the sorting in between of these two. It is easy to do this process because the size is less compared to the large amount of file. Okay, so do the sort internally in between these two portions. Finally, this is the sorted order list. Again, perform sorting in these two portions. Again, do the final sorted list. Finally, these two portions which is sorted in earlier, those portions again sorting to each other. Sorting to each other, then finally all the elements should be in order. Okay, that was what I am explaining from the beginning onwards. External sorting is done at two places. Okay, data is one place, processing is done another place. So data is placed at hard disk and some portion of data we have picked from the hard disk, do the sorting in the internal, that is a primary memory, then resultant, that means sorted data, will be again throw back to the hard disk. This is the external sorting. For this sorting mechanism, we are take the support of merge sort to do such kind of activity. So this is also called as divide and conquer method. Divide and conquer method. Divide and conquer method in the sense, entire file will be divided into several parts, and after sorting all parts again combined into single file. So divide in the sense divide, conquer means combining all portions into again single file. Okay, so that is about summary of internal and external sorting. Okay, next, what is the comparisons table? Just see the comparison table differences. Here, internal sorting versus external sorting. Maybe they ask the 2 marks questions for only differences, but 99% having the chance to ask either several key sorting or internal or external sorting. Okay, they'll ask the general questions. What is internal sorting? What is external sorting? Which are internal? Which are external? Explain anyone from the internal sorting and external sorting. Okay, so such kind of question they ask. A chance to ask because it is the first time to adding a data structure syllabus. Okay, same thing, if you know the conceptually how internal sorting, external sorting, easy to write the differentiate. Okay, work only on small data. Okay, data list large enough not to fit in the main memory. Okay, data size is enough, if not able, not fit into the main memory, we can only take suitable data from the hard disk and do the sorting process. Require only sorting process. It required sorting and merging process. Merging in the sense combining two. Finally, at last, after finding all the portions of the data, then we can combine and give it back to the hard disk. So as I said earlier, it is a faster, it is a slower because of involvement of storage classes, storage devices. Okay, example, bubble sort, selection, all the sorting techniques comes under the internal sorting except merge sort. So this is the total topic on merge sort. So this is the syllabus and this is the completion of 5th unit. And here don't panic, what is list sorting, what is table sorting? Yes, you know the answer, you know the answer, but their terminologies differ. List sorting in the sense linked list having the elements, the list should be arranged into order, that is the list order. Okay, next, table sorting. Table sorting in a sense like hash. Okay, hash function. So just now hash function we are place the data in their respective positions, but after placing the data into the hash table, check again either it is sorted or not. If it is not sorted order, do the or apply any of the sorting method, make the data into order. That is a table sorting. We know we have the prior knowledge on the sorting, but the terminology is list and table. Table in the sense we have stored the table, we have stored the data in table form, and we have to check whether the elements in the table in sorted order or not. If it is not sorted order, apply any of the sorting method, make the data into order. Okay, if the data size is less, go for plenty of sorting methods. If the data size is high, go for merge sort. This is the only one option we are having. Okay, so merge sort is also called as divide and conquer. It is following the divide and conquer method. If they suppose they ask 2 marks question, divide and conquer method means dividing the input data into several parts and find the solution of all the parts and combine all the solution into single portion. That is a divide and conquer method. That means what I shown the figure here, this is a divide and conquer. So this is a file, unsorted order. So for our comfortability, divided into small pieces, and we are combining two portions, make it into order. Again, we are combining two portions, make it into order. Finally, these two portions make it into order. That is a divide and conquer. Divide first, then after solving all the portions, make it as a one. Okay, so that's about the syllabus.